Greetings, minions! I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Darksiders Warmastered Edition on that there PC. Yes, I was going to make a joke about this being Arthur's Rise of the Lich King, but number one, that's a gag about a novelization that I imagine not many people care about, and frankly, I've made enough jokes about war looking like Arthur's the Lich King, so there we go. Such ow, okay. Yeah, it's been just long enough since the last time I played this, me to have forgotten everything about how to fight these enemies, so... Yeah. I mean, granted, it's nice that this chap's smaller friends don't appear to be all that interested in beating me up. Also, this guy doesn't really seem to be all that interested in beating me up either. I was gonna say, like, that death of his there could have been entirely avoided had he just, you know, cared a bit about what was going to happen to him if he didn't fight back properly. But instead, his giant bony ass decided to largely not hit me. Then again, that is kind of a central conceit, I suppose. Kind of one of the central conceits of a lot of games like this, or a lot of games in general, is that of course the AI isn't going to be a colossal dickbag to you, because then you would just die. Yeah, you can just, you big bulbous guy, you just go play with my boomerang for a while, is what I think you should do. There you go, here's a boomerang. Play with that. Look, mate. Play with the boomerang. You don't need to worry about combat, friend. You are clearly a sick, sick man. And all you need to worry about... Ah, damn it. There you go. And all you need to worry about... Clearly... is the boomerang. And, you know, getting your head quite aggressively torn off your body, and then dying for a very long time. You know what that... Oh, fucking... Okay, yep, forgot that happened. Lovely. Ooh, hello. Sword, excellent. Wait, really? Who dares? I'll tell you who dares. War dares! War dares the crap out of it. Largely because you chaps aren't actually as threatening as you seem to think you are. You know what I mean? There's kind of an upper limit to how threatening dead people can possibly ever seem. Do you know what I mean? Because you can't be that great, because you died in your armor, you know what I mean? Like, you died in battle, which means someone beat you to death. A warrior who never died in battle, I'd argue, like a famous warrior who never died in battle, is a lot more threatening than one who does. For the simple reason that, as I believe is implied, if you died in battle, as I believe I just said, if you died in battle, someone beat you. Makes it a lot more believable that I could likely beat you. Especially, you know, what with being war. You know, the literal. But, you know, what with being war. And as in, you know, war, literal embodiment of said. I'm trying to remember which way I actually have to go now. Oh, okay, I have to go back this way. I understand. I mean, you can honestly think, if you had to think of a way, if you had to pick a fight with, you know, any given, like, potent mythological figure, I don't know about you, but war would have been, like, for me at least, war would be, like, the last guy. You know what I mean? He's war! Like, he's the war, he's the embodiment of violence. You're not gonna win in a fight with that guy. You know what I mean? He's fucking spooky as war. He's a big, horrible chap. Big, horrible chap with a massive, horrible sword and probably an axe to grind with you, specifically, maybe. I don't know, because you're dumb and mean, probably. But, like, well, if you're picking a fight with war, you just have to be dumb. Mean, not necessarily. You might genuinely just be a good person who just thinks the world would be better off without the physical embodiment of violence running around. Gonna be honest, I didn't think that I was gonna get locked in here when I did that. I was expecting a new entrance to open or something. Although, no, that is actually happening. I'll give you that one. A new place has opened up. It's just above. It just went above. Hello, chaps. Where am I? Why was that even seen? Why was that even magically seen? Have I been? Oh no, yeah, I've been here before. Of course, that's why it was magically sealed, to stop me from getting in there before. Good! Fills me with confidence, that. I don't know about you, ladies and gentlemen, but if I walk through a door and then that door magically seals itself behind me, I think that I'm in good company. I think that I am gonna have a nice time. Know what I mean? The things are gonna go really very well for me, that my life is going to be nothing but sunshine and happiness for the rest of time, as long as the door is sealed behind me. What an impressive fire not going out under that much rain.
Has the council reduced the horsemen to common assassins? Or has Samael bought your loyalty? Because if you are for sale, Ryder, perhaps we can strike a deal.
You won't like my terms.
Okay, well, that was unfortunate, because it seemed that Tiamat was actually willing to be reasonable there, and we just refused.
You should have considered my offer.
I mean, technically, you didn't really make an offer. Let's be honest. Ow. Oh dear, this fight's gonna kill me, I feel. Largely, because I can't remember how it goes. Okay, I remember that it's supposed to... There we go. Okay, good. I do still recall what we're doing. You know, if I'm gonna fucking beat the shit out of a giant bat, probably hit its face. Also, I really should have gone and got more health stuff first. You know, you keep saying that I should have considered your offer when... If we're being honest here, Tiamat, you didn't really make one. Ow. What you did was more, like... bring up the vague possibility that you might be willing to make a deal. And then just like... Ow. Yeah, what you did more was just bring up the vague possibility that you might be willing to make a deal. And then we started fighting. You know what I mean? That's not really, not really an offer. Ow. I am so very dead. Whoop. Oh, maybe I'm not. No, because I fucking punched Tiamat right in the fucking face. What are you doing? Ah! Oh my god, okay, so I'm not quite dead. But give it like 10 seconds and I will be a corpse. Is I believe what is currently going on here. Can I do this at you? Okay, you see me running straight at me quite a lot, and I'm not quite sure as to what the purpose of that is. Because it's fairly obviously not doing much for you. I mean, okay, now. Now you're walking at me slowly, which has got me worried. And now I'm dead. But I don't know, I don't trust things that walk at me slowly. You know what I mean? I also just decided to turn my fan off because the fan sound was distracting me a bit. Yep, can I skip this? Can we skip? Okay, good, we can skip! Perfect! Okay, now we have to, now let's try that one again. But let's try it a bit less stupid. I think a bit less stupid would help us. If I was a bit less dense. You know what I mean? If I dodged a bit more. Okay, so let you breathe your fire. There you go, you breathe your fire. Where's the fucking... There it is. There we go, that's better. Now things are going more my way, although it must be said I do resent the complete and utter lack of a health bar. I find that in some way demeaning.
This will not end well for you, horseman.
But it's already not ended well for me once, so... Honestly, you're not wrong. I'm still shit at dodging you, so... Awesome, right, come crashing down, biggin. Ah, lovely. As I said, it is odd of you to decide to crash onto this bit of land as opposed to literally anywhere else. Ow! Because if I was you, I'd land somewhere else. Preferably somewhere where there wasn't one of the four horsemen of the apocalypse, but hey, that's just me. I have entirely too much trouble dodging that large explosive attack. Largely because this, because that's the kind of thing you expect to have to dodge, like, once, as opposed to like having to do a double dodge for it. You know what I mean? Okay, yes, so it is consistently. Okay, no, that time there wasn't even any fucking, like, I dodged one attack, so fucking Tiamat immediately went into a different attack that I couldn't dodge at that point. Come along. Punch you in the fucking eye. Okay, dead again. Yeah, it's not helped with the fact that I can't, that there isn't like a health bar for Tiamat, so I don't actually know whether or not I'm doing any damage to Tiamat. Do you know what I mean? Because sometimes when you hit Tiamat, I don't know if it comes across in the video or not, but sometimes like there's a bit of a rumble. You know what I mean? There's a bit of rumble in the controller. I can't quite tell if anything happened, if anything's coming out on the video for that, but like if there's a sound effect or something, but ah shit. Excellent. Land. But yeah, no, because like right now there's a bit of a rumble. So yeah, there's a bit of a visual rumble there compared to now when there isn't. Like, were those follow-up strikes still doing damage, or were they pointless?
You should have considered my offer. Such a pity.
Huh? Well, I can throw those quite a distance. Come on. Come on, you damn dirty bat! I'll fucking have you, mate! There we go. Down you come. Come along. Like that, again, trying to dodge one of Tiamat's attacks. To which the game responded by having Tiamat change it into a different attack. A different attack, which at that point from that range, it's incredibly difficult to dodge, let alone even tell that it's changed into a different attack. Also, I really need to use the, that a bit more often. Ow. Because it seems to, look at that! It's like you dodge the big ranged attack, and then immediately, without fucking thinking about it, Tiamat just goes, yeah, no, we're doing a different attack now. Ow. So I'm gonna do that, and then, yep, turns into a big fucking slam. Oh, did we win this time? You know what? I think we've won. Because I think the point at which you're fighting the Bat Queen and you slide and you rip the Bat Queen's, wings up at the moment you've won, you know what I mean?
Do it! Tear out her heart while she still lives! I want to hear her scream! I am one of the chosen. I can grant your every wish.
Can you restore the balance?
wonder Samael wants this thing. It's coursing with power. You really think he's going to let you live long enough to collect on your end?
That's a big, red, juicy heart full of, like... Full of, just covered in stone. Oh, cool, we got another heart thing. Also, just want to say, Mark Hamill, you are a grim little son of a bitch, you know that? Like, just depressing. Like, I want to hear scream! Like, calm down, mate. To this point, the war just looks at us like, ah, shit.
Tragic. Without your feathered friend, how will you escape this prison of rock?
I'll find a way.
You have certainly proven yourself resourceful. Perhaps I can provide a quicker way.
Speak plainly, demon.
Serpent holes, ancient paths that worm their way beneath the husk of this dead world and beyond. I use them to get about, and for a price, so can you.
What do you want, Voldrum?
A trifle, really? The Chosen's heart. I felt its power the moment you stepped from that tower. You wound me, horseman. I would never come between you and your friend Samael. No, I only wish to look at the heart. One glance, and our bargain is sealed. Samael will be pleased. The serpent holes are yours, horseman. Seek me out when you wish to use them.
Awesome, we have quick travel. Excellent. This is the this is the main reason why Volgrim is important. But no, now Volgrim is actually more important to find the little spots where he can be found, because we need the serpent holes to teleport everywhere. And I'm just trying to remember. I'm trying to remember where it is that we... I'm assuming that it would be the crossroads that's currently the closest serpent hole we have? Or the closest Volgrim location we have? Also, this is actually something I've never understood about the serpent holes, right? I think I actually mentioned this when I did a shenanigans of this a while ago. The serpent holes, this is what they look like. I quite like the look of them. They do kind of look like these weird kind of ruined parts of a world that are like just kind of stuck in a void with some light platforming. Like some very light platforming. But I've never understood why they are here from like a gameplay perspective. Like... Obviously say, yes, you use the serpent holes to travel, but why make us walk through the fuckers? Do you know what I mean? Like, what is gained by actually making us walk through them? Greetings. Don't say greetings to me when I'm walking away from you, Vulcan. I've got no interest in it. Got no fucking interest in talking to you right now. Like, none whatso-fucking-ever. I'm also just not going to interact with any... Oh, fuck me, I nearly fell down. Oh, no, wait, that's... Actually, it's scared me, isn't it? Can I go under this water? Yes, I can. Is there anything under? Oh, hello. I was wondering if there was anything under here, because there are some secrets kind of dotted around the world. Nothing of any fucking value. Okay. Just a health pickup. That's a bit shit. It just never occurred to me to look down, man. Thing is, with games that have that kind of, lots of, exploration reward pickups, like, I tend to just not find most of them, because I'm not really into exploration, you know, as a primary gameplay conceit. Like, it's just not something I'm typically particularly fond of. I'm not a 100%er. Do you know what I mean? I'm a get to the end of the main campaign kind of guy, and then if it ends up being like a game I fucking love, then I'll play more of it. But I'm never the kind of guy who, like, on his first playthrough is going to try to find everything. Like, I think I've only 100%ed a game once, and I think that was fucking, like, Spyro 2 on the PlayStation 1. Do you know what I mean? And even then, actually, that wasn't even when I was a kid. That was actually fairly recently. It was when I was, it was about a year ago. I got bored, so I decided to 100% that. Ah, well, such is life. Samael, I've got your fucking weird, gross thing.
I trust that she suffered.
Not nearly enough.
Beautiful. The second guardian, the Griever, moves in tunnels beneath this place. But first there is an obstacle that must be removed. Ulthane, one of the old ones.
You didn't mention that before.
Changing the deal already, Samael.
Be silent, Bilth. My business is with the horsemen. Ulthane is no ally of the Destroyer. But you won't find the Griever without confronting the Black Hammer. And that will require strength you don't possess. Yet.
What the hell do you think you're doing, Samael?
Tell him, Watcher, how you stifle the horseman's true power in order to keep him on the Council's leash. War, destroy this parasite.
You so much as blink at me, and the Council will end you, both of you. I'm protected.
Not in here. You are War, rider of the Red Horse. Not some puppet on this pathetic creature's strings.
War, I will make you suffer.
Focus your anger. A great rage stirs within you, clawing to get out. You must release it, or a puppet you will remain. You are reborn.
What was that?
The horseman is broken, but there is still much power in him. For a moment, I saw one who would stand alone against the Destroyer's army.
Okay, cool. So we now have our weird rage form. Lovely. Yeah, the chaos form. Excellent. However, that seems like a good place to stop, actually, looking at the time and where we are. It's weird how so often it seems that about that every half an hour it turns into just actually a good place to stop. Okay, so that's got to be all for me for now. I've been your humble Darksiders Thinker, and as always, keep calm, carry on, good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Right, let's cut the crap to this end slate, it doesn't take forever. I want to thank these lovely minions, whose names are on the screen right now, for donating to my Patreon campaign to help keep the channel going. If you want to donate as well and get your name on this list and the one in the description, you can follow the link in the description to my Patreon page and pledge some money there, it would be appreciated. Down there you will also find a link to my Twitter, where I post random bullshit, ranty bullshit, and indeed every single video I put up, because Lord knows, you can't trust YouTube to do it for you anymore. Right, we done? Is it over?
It's over!